Dear Chairman of the Union of Arab Banks, Excellencies, dear Minister, dear Governor of Central Bank, distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen, it is an honor and pleasure to address you today in the International Arab Banking Summit. I am advisor to the Executive Board of the European Central Bank. For several years already, I have participated with high interest in events organized by the Union of Arab Banks and the Arab Banking Association. Key issues which are heavily impacting transparency and financial stability have been addressed in this forum, such as regulatory framework regarding international taxations, money laundering, combating terrorist financing, correspondent banking, and green finance. These are topics which are under the radar of the G20 and G7. At the ECB, there is always a strong interest to have fruitful exchanges of views on such topics with you, leading bankers and high-level representatives of the public and private sector. It is for us fundamental to regularly exchange views, concerns, shaping new ideas to address finance in an unpredictable world, like the very appropriate title of this present IASB Summit suggests. We are currently seeing widespread concerns in many parts of the world regarding free trade and globalized finance. Dismantling regulatory standards is also more and more often referred to, but it would only make financial markets less safe. Despite daunting challenges, the EU and the euro area in particular have a track record of overcoming common challenges through cooperation. The creation of a single banking supervisor for the euro area, along with a single framework for bank recovery and resolution, is a recent case in point. It has created a level playing field for banks operating across the euro area that strengthens financial stability, eliminates double standards, and can protect European taxpayers. In other terms, over the last 4 years, we have made significant progress at the European level with the establishment of the banking union. The ECB has helped and will continue to help to bring forward the two processes of risk reduction and risk sharing within its mandate as a central bank and as a supervisor. In this context, accelerating the work on creating a European deposit insurance scheme is essential, as is introducing a common backstop for the Single Resolution Fund. In parallel, the European Commission package reviewing the current EU regulatory framework for banks is moving in the right direction in terms of risk reduction measures. It is crucial that we complete the post-crisis reform package and do not undo the progress made in recent years. The ECB will continue to support the work at international level to achieve an appropriate regulatory framework that establishes a level playing field. This may be an appropriate point to thank Mr. Fatou, Secretary of the General Union of Arab Banks, for organizing this summit, which I trust will be a highly interesting, engaging, and beneficial opportunity for all of us present here today. Thank you.